Hello everyone. As always, it is Kelly with the Hammond Branch Library for another teen program. And today's theme is the National Puzzle Day. I bet you didn't know there was a National Puzzle Day. And if you did, you are already several steps ahead of me because tomorrow, January 29th, is the day we will celebrate puzzles. Now, I wanted to show you before we get started how we'll be celebrating National Puzzle Day here at the Hammond Branch. So if you come to pick up any of our team grab and goes, we will be having these little puzzle pieces here, or rather you can make these and make your own puzzle cork board so you can save whatever memories or important ideas that you want to keep. And my favorite part is it's also magnetic, so you can put it on whatever surface you want to keep those memories on. All right, now what I want to share with you today is the story of a puzzle called The Sisters of Stray Garden Place, which is a book by Haley Chewins. In this story, many things begin to disappear. Most importantly, what disappears are the girls' parents. So you get to follow along as they try to uncover what has happened not only to their parents, but what has caused the strange silver grass that likes to take things to grow so tall that has eclipsed the house. And why is it that they don't sleep anymore? So if you're curious about these puzzles and would like to know the answers, I'm not going to put it together for you, but it will be here to check out when you're ready. Now, this is my copy of the book, but when you get it, it might look a little different. So let's finish this here. That's about it. Your cover is going to look a little something like this, but it will be all in one piece. Promise. If it isn't, you should definitely let us know, okay? But what kind of puzzles do you enjoy? I want you to think about whatever it is you like to do when you work on a puzzle. Do you like number puzzles like Sudoku? Do you like crossword puzzles? I can tell you we have at least one programmer here who absolutely adores crossword puzzles. It's Miss Lauren. I promise you, if you ask her, she will share some with you. She might have completed them already, but she absolutely loves them. Myself, I like riddles, but my favorite kind of puzzle is actually called a rebus. It's kind of a visual puzzle that still involves words. I'll let you have a look here. Now, if you've never seen a rebus, this might look like a lot of nonsense to you, but I'm going to show you how you decode it. Rebuses are cool because you have to pay attention not just to the words, but to what is visible, what isn't visible, and how they're placed in relation to each other. So here we have injury plus insult. That means you are adding insult to injury. A lot of rebus puzzles are to tell you some kind of phrase or title that you would be familiar with. So here's another one. It's a cat. And you see here, it's kind of a bag that has a big opening in between it, almost like something just came out of it. That's because someone let the cat out of the bag. I know it seems silly, but they actually get really complicated. And some of them I still haven't worked out myself. But if you're interested in discovering a new type of puzzle or trying it, take a look. I will hold this for you. And see how many of these you can solve. If you're interested in more, you should definitely check your local library. I'm told that there might be at least one person who can help you. So, before I let you go, I want to know what kind of puzzles you enjoy, and more importantly, what is your puzzle style? Do you like to finish the puzzle all around the edges first? Do you like to put together all the colors that look the same? Do you put together the words? Or do you enjoy a challenge? Do you flip the puzzle over so that you can't see any of the images and just put it together by shape alone? I know a person that only looks at the box with the puzzle image when they're done, because they don't want any kind of hint about what that puzzle should look like before they put it together. Myself, I really like doing puzzles with friends, but there's a competitive part of me that likes to race them to see how quickly I can put it together. This has been nice because when I can't see my family, I can still race them to complete the puzzle. So if you had to think about your puzzle style, what would it be? If you were a puzzle, what would your day be? What would your year be? I want to know which part of your life you would put together first, which part you rush to finish, which part you're proud to show off. And I want to know what that picture looks when you're done. I figured this is a good time to think about that. Since it's January and lots of other people are working on resolutions, we can work on puzzles. Until then, until next time, I'm Kelly. Can't wait to see you again. Bye.